What is the closing argument, Ed, of your candidate?
Well, by and large, McCain is, Obama rather, is able to get away with platitudes. He says things like, you know, we're for justice and we're for peace and we're for prosperity. We're for
unity.
Unity is a platitude.
It is?
Yeah, it is.
Why doesn't your party use it?
And keep in mind that the race.
You guys never use it.
They used to, Chris.
Because it's not celebrated and it doesn't get away as an applause line if McCain used it. Who's against unity, Chris? Come on, be fair. But the fact of the matter is, this race is still very close. It's within 4 to 7 points. McCain needs to make up a point a day, and he can still win.
Okay, so I agree with that. Let's watch him now. Here's Senator McCain talking today about Obama trying to control wealth rather than produce it.
He's more interested in controlling wealth than creating it. In redistributing money instead of spreading opportunity. I'm going to create wealth for all Americans by creating opportunity for all Americans.
How does that reach the undecided voter? It seems like that's a very effective plea, Ed Rogers, to the Republican base. It's hard Republican economics, which we've been under for the last 8 years. Why would that sell now?
And right now, you're right. Republicans are not credible on the economy. He needs to make a broader point about Obama doesn't have an economic plan. He has an ideological belief that he should take money from one person and give it to another. That doesn't create wealth. That doesn't create jobs. That doesn't create an economy in which people can seek opportunity.
How does he do that? Just tell me what the method is for Obama. Explain what you mean by that.
How Obama does it, or how McCain
does it?
How
Obama would take money from some people and give to others. Who would he take from?
Well, let's take what he has said. He will take money from people that he wants to raise taxes on.
Who are they?
He told Joe the plumber.
And who would those people be?
Well, ultimately, it's all of us. He wants to raise Social Security taxes.
That is a lie. That is a lie.
He wants to raise...
Ed, it's a lie. It's a lie, and I'm not going to let you say it. It's a lie. It is a lie.
On capital gains and interest income.
Okay, slow down here.
It's not a lie at all.
Okay, your point is he wants to take from everybody.
And you know why it's not working? You know why it's not working?
He wants to give to people that support it.
It's not working. It's not working for a simple reason that Chris alluded to in the last segment. People are not interested in these abstract. You know, Ed, you talked a long time. People are not interested in these abstract discussions about progressive income tax. People are for the progressive income tax. They know that Obama gives a tax cut to everybody under $200,000 and to 95% of the American people. And you know what? You're ashamed to say who would pay more, because the people who would pay more are the people at the top. They would pay slightly more what they paid under Bill Clinton when, by the way, we created a lot of jobs
what
and had a very prosperous economy.
What is it about today's economy that suggests a tax increase is the solution?
Well,
we need to cut the corporate income tax.
Is it better to borrow more money from China or to raise taxes? What's better?
What's better?
Because you have to do one or the other.
Better? No, you don't.
Oh, where do you get this money from?
You can grow your way out of it. You can grow your way out of the deficit. That's what we did before.
The problem is the problem is right now nobody's borrowing money, nobody's lending money. Our economic situation is at a standstill. We got a real challenge out there, and I just wonder what kickstarts it.
And what is the problem? We're raising taxes is the solution in today's economy.
He is giving a tax cut to the middle class. He is putting taxes back to the level for the very wealthiest. Ed, let me finish. I am being honest. You guys have been lying for the last month consistently. Because you can't win this on a straight up and down economic choice. And in fact, McCain's own people said
we
can't win on the economy.
He's right. You agree. What I find fascinating, and you guys have all, like I have been watching these polls all our lives, frankly, when the Democrats have broken even with the Republicans on the tax issue, which has always been your party's strength, what's your problem?
Yeah.
How come that happened?
Well,
how come his argument, whatever it is winning?
Because we are not credible on the economy. We have an incumbent that is at 10% job approval on the economy. Even though McCain
he cut taxes, he did everything you said a Republican should do, and this is where we're at.
How philosophical do you want to get?
No, I'm just saying where we're at because of Republican policies.
McCain is a legitimate opponent of the status quo in Washington, period. He should get credit for that. He always has been. He's not for more of the same.
He supports the Bush tax cuts.
More of the same, plus some. A pro-growth economic philosophy.
But it doesn't work.
Obama doesn't have an economic philosophy. He has an ideological philosophy of redistributing the wealth. He does.
Oh, come on.
Let me ask you, Bob Schrum, let's elevate this for 1 minute here. When Barack Obama gets into the White House, will he be the kind of interesting pragmatist like Jack Kennedy was back in the 60s, where he put together a cabinet? It was basically about fiscal, you know, stimulus, tax cuts at the right time. He tried to get them through, never could. But he really bounced it off by putting Doug Dillon as Treasury Secretary, Eisenhower person. Do you think Barack's going to do that? Will he put together a solid centrist team to push his agenda? What kind of administration do you think he'll put together?
I think he'll be a pragmatist if he wins. I think he will have Republicans in the cabinet. I think he'll propose national health care reform, and I think he'll give tax cuts to the middle class. And I think people will say, that's pretty much what we want. And then he's going to have to go on and face some of the big challenges that we have, which is how do we prepare to compete with China, India, educate our kids, stuff like that.
Everything that's easy to be done in Washington has been done.
Well,
we need a president who can do hard things. He's never done one hard thing in his life. He said,
that's not true. You know what? Let me tell you something.
Go, Bob,
somebody from the South shouldn't say that a black person running for president's never done a hard thing in their life.
Don't you even go there.
Okay.
Obama's never done one hard thing in his life.
I do this, Bob.
What?
Let's drop this.
Wrong.
I think the problem is what you address, which is the ends get blamed when things go bad. And your party's the ends right now. Thank